Yeah, okay, okay. Just a few minutes about the group manager component of SocIoTal. The group manager is one of the new addition of the functional components of the security of the SocIoTal security framework, and this component of the architecture is intended to deal with communication or in general with the concept of group and for the IoT. Actually, the concept of group in IoT is very important because it's very likely that devices often will be operate together to do some tasks, to collaborate or to share information to provide, for example, more accurate measurements. And security and privacy, the application of security and privacy mechanisms to deal with that, with those definitions of group is particularly challenging. And the SocIoTal group manager, as already mentioned, is basically intended to cope with the definition and management of groups. And in SocIoTal, we have defined some kinds of different kinds of communities and bubbles that can be defined according to relationship between users or even smart objects from users, and also to manage with more flexibility sharing models in which data can be even shared with devices that are not previously known by a producer of information, and. The main foundation behind the group manager, the SocIoTal group manager, is the application of the ciphertext policy attribute-based encryption. It's a recent, let's say, recent cryptographic scheme that it provides a higher degree of flexibility to deal with groups compared to more classical approaches based on symmetric key cryptography, for example. Basically, in CPAB, private keys are associated with a set of identity attributes, the identity attributes of a user, of a device, even a device, a smart object, whatever. And the information from a producer is not encrypted with the public key. It's more typical or asymmetric key of a group or a public key with the receiver, but with a combination or under a combination or policy of identity attributes that make reference to the entities that will be able to decrypt the information. So in this case, the application CPAB enables data producer can exert a greater control about how his information is disseminated to another entities. And it's basically what I already mentioned, the comparison with, for example, the symmetric key cryptography, that you need to define a symmetric key for a group of entities. In this case, groups, the concept of group can be realized more in a more dynamic way or more on demand way. In this case, in the same way that for authorization, we are using Quad DTLS to apply for or deliver CPAB keys. And we have already integrated this mechanism, this group manager component, with the SocIoTal context manager that enables to share information. For example, you can have a set of subscribers, a set of entities that are subscribed to a specific information from an entity, and this entity is encrypting data with a specific combination of identity attributes that will enable to a secure group communication with the subscribers. And this is basically the main components of the group manager component. And first, a group manager client that first it will apply for CPAB keys to the group manager server or attribute authority. And this is a library that is compatible for Android devices, and it provides the functionality to encrypt and decrypt information. The group manager server is a Quad DTLS server. that is currently running at the University of Murcia, and we are using, in this case, we are using the attributes that are contained in the certificate from the clients to generate the CPAB keys associated to those attributes. And this is basically the main scenario, main integration scenario with the SocIoTal Context Manager, and this is basically the scenario of the demo. And basically, we have a set of data producers that can push, they can put information of the SocIoTal Context Manager, and after that, it's okay. No, that's basically the scenario of the.
Nobody can read any of this text on this picture, so we can.
Yeah.
The main idea is that we are able to encrypt the information that is put in a context manager in the broker, and then the broker deliver to the subscribers all the information, but the information is encrypted. So the context manager is not aware of the information that is going through the context manager. The producer encrypt the information with a policy of attributes, and then only the subscriber that satisfies identity attributes are able to decrypt the information. So we ensure confidentiality of the information that is goes through the context manager. So if we can show you, if you want, a short demo of this, where we have a producer and a subscriber, and the producer encrypts the information, sends to the broker, and the subscriber receives the information encrypted, and since it has the proper attributes, it has the proper keys, so it can decrypt the information. Just a minute.